Hello, welcome to the third part of Build a Portfolio with Django. So, in this part, we are going to be talking about the views and the template. Firstly, the views is where we define all the logics of our Django applications. That is, how we are going to get data from our database and send it to the template. Meanwhile, the template is where we get data from the views and display it to the end user. So, to start, we are going to go to the app we created. Mine was called John. In that app, you're going to see the file called views.py. As you can see, the file is empty. So I'm going to go ahead and create this basic view. So basically, a view takes in a request, like if you request for a home or for a page on a website, that is going to initiate this view, maybe called index.html, and then that view also is going to return something. That is, it takes in a request and then it returns something. In this case, it's going to return a page called index.html, which we have not yet created. So, but when you create a view, you have to create the link that is going to activate this view. So for me to do that, we have to create a new file called url.py. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to create a file called url.py. So now in this file, this is where I'm going to define all the URLs of my application or of my app called John, because these URLs are going to is in the app called John. Okay, I've gone ahead and created the URLs for my John app. So basically, I'm importing part from Django.urls, and then I'm importing from dot or from this directory. I import all my views, which are these. So here I have only one view, which is called index. So here I'm going to define the path. This path means once I call for that domain of my website or the main, like for example, here we have the local host, which is the port 8000. So once you call for port 8000, it's going to call for this view. So in the views, I'm having views.index. So it comes here and get this view, which is going to return an index.html page. So basically, this is what happens. So now, in our app, we have a file called urls.py, but now, basically, our project doesn't know about it. So remember, the project is called Portfolio O. You might have the name of your own project. So, but mine was called Portfolio. So in that my file, I have another file called I have another file called urls.py. So what I want to do now is I'm going to add these URLs, this route to this app in this main file. Like this, where this is a file that contains all my URLs. So for Django to know that I have another route in this app, I have to come and add that app here. So I'm going to include, or I'm going to import include. Yeah, once I've imported include, now I'm going to go ahead and register now that app or the URLs from John here. Okay, so now after importing include, I'm going to now include the URLs from John. So but I'm increasing this directory, this the origin or the local host or the name of your domain here. Then now I add the URLs in john.url. So with this, I've set the URLs from this app called John. Now what I can do now is I have to go now and test this out, but remember I have no index page, so we're going to go ahead now and create that index page, index.html. So if you come to my route, well basically let me just explain this. Here I've called for the views called index, and then for this view, I've just given a name to the view or the name to this route, which is called index. So if you come here, I'm getting a request, then I'm sending in, and then the view is getting in a request and then outputting an index.html page. So I'm going to go ahead and create that page. So here you have to create a new folder, and the folder is going to be called template. That's where we're going to put all the HTML or the front end of our app. So in this folder called template, now I'm going to create a file called index.html. So I'm going to put index www.jonathanbrown.html. All right, that's it. Basically, I've created the app. And here we go. All right, so I've gone ahead and created this basic template. Then now I'm just going to create an H1 tag. Right, I'll say hello. Okay, this means in each time I call for this view, it's going to return the index.html page. So now let's go ahead and run the server. So I'm going to open my terminal and here we go. All right, my virtual environment is being activated automatically because I have the Python extension installed in my VS Code. So if you want to install that, you have to come to extension, then now you search for the Python, you come here, then I search for Python. Well, each time you open a Python file on your VS Code, it's going to ask you to install the Python extension, which is this. So once that is installed, it's going to obviously detect my virtual environment and activate it for me. But if you don't know how to install it, you can go to the basic setup or the first video which I show you how to install it. So right now we are going to run the server. So pythonman.py run server. All right, my server is running on port 8000 and then I'm going to go there. All right, as you can see, we have set up a simple view, as this is a hello from that view. So what this means is that, you remember, the route had nothing. It means each time I request for my main page, it's going to show me, it's going to output this index.html. So if I come here, okay, as you can see, we're able to call for this index page from our website. So now if I go ahead and change this, maybe let's say I call this John. All right, it means I've said to Django that each time I call for anything slash John is going to output it. So for example, if I refresh this page, you're going to see that nothing is here now. But once I do John, it returns back that page, because here in my urls.py, I've said each time I call for slash here, John is going to call now for these views, which is called index, and that views is going to return this index.html page, as you can see here. So I have hello. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put this back to how it works. All right, so that's it. Then fix this back and there we go, we have a hello. So basically, we have written and configured a simple view in Django using this HTML page. So what happens is a request is being sent on our website, which outputs now this index.html page. So what we want to do now is to add all the styling or the front end of our website in the template here. So for that, since this course is basically, or this tutorial is basically on Django, I'm not going to actually show you how to build the front end, but I'm going to link you up to how to build that. So you can use this link. I'm going to leave the link in the description. They open it, it's going to give you this page, which is the repository to the website or the front end, the static pages. Once you're on this page, now what you want to do is you click here and then you press download zip. It's going to go ahead and download the folder. Or if you would like to watch the YouTube video on how to build the static website, you can click on this link here, watch it on YouTube, which is going to show you how to actually build the front end, that front end. So now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get that folder from my download directory. All right, so I'm going to go to download, and this is a folder I downloaded. So I'm just going to copy that, move that to my desktop, and there we go. I'm going to extract it here. Okay, that was extracted. Now I can delete this. So this is a page here. So I'm going to come here and I'll copy this index.html and this asset page. So index.html, I'm going to copy that into my working directory. So my working directory is here, Django. So I'm going to open that, then I'll paste it here. Alright, as you can see, I've added a folder called asset. Then I'm going to create this index.html and put it in the folder called in the templates of John. So I'm just going to replace this. And now that's it. I've added that. And then I open my working directory. So I have replaced the index.html file with a new front end folder, and this is that asset folder. This asset just contains the CSS, the images, and the JS file from the front end, which you can follow in the video I linked. So now let's go ahead and see what happens. If you come now to your front end, then you refresh, you're going to have this. All right, I know a lot of people did not expect this. This is because the website, remember, the website has Hello, has Home, About, Skills, Portfolio. So the website now is looking ugly because there is no styling. We have not told Django where to find the styling, that is the CSS, the JavaScript files. So if you come to your index.html file, you're going to see that here we have CSS file, and then we have the JavaScript files at the bottom. But now the problem is that Django doesn't know where to find those files. And for you to tell Django, you have to use the Django templating language. That's where we start using now the templates. So that is why we start linking out the views and the template, the views and the template. So what we are going to do now is we are going to add all the Django templates, templating styles here, so that Django will be able to see where our assets are, where our CSS and all these other styling files are found. So before that, we are going to copy all these assets. So remember, we are in the folder here. This is the folder called Django. So these are assets folder from the front end, which contains the CSS, the images, the JS, and the SAS. So what we want to do now is we have to copy this folder. So I'm going to cut that, sorry. I'm going to cut this folder and put it, initially let's just know where we are going to put. So if you go to your settings.py, in part 2 we define a static root, that is where we're going to define the static files directory where we're going to save all our static files. That is, this is a file where Django is going to look for all the static files, and CSS, JavaScript are static files since they are files that won't change. So here I'm going to create a new directory called static. Okay, that's it. I've created a directory called static. Then I'm going to paste the asset folder into it. So now I have pasted the asset folder into it. So now I'm just going to close it. So Django is going to come and be looking for all the assets here. So I've closed that up. Then now I have to come now. What I have to do is I have to add that to Django. So I'm just going to copy this. Okay. Okay. Yeah, what we have done is we have told Django where to find the static file called styles.css. That is, Django is going to use this as a reference, which is going to tell Django to look for the file for this style.css in the folder called static. In static, we have asset which has CSS, then now style.css. So Django knows now where to find the CSS file. So before that, there's a step I omitted. So what we want to do here is we want to load static. Sorry, this just tells Django that we are going to be using static on this page. So after that, if you come now and then let's say refresh the page. Wow, as you can see, everything just looks better because now the CSS files are being loaded. So we're going to go ahead and load all the static files. So let me go ahead and load all the files. So I'm going to use this string tag again. I'm just going to copy this. That's for the front. So if I come here, have no static file. I have no static file here. Okay. Just to be sure I did not omit anything. Okay, this I'm not going to add like the load static here on this URL because this is a URL that is going to fetch the data. Like each time you load the page, it's going to use this route to fetch the CSS that is on this page. So you don't need to do that on URLs, but each file, like each static file that is on the Django project, you have to actually pass in this tag to tell Django where to find the static file. So I'm just going to go down and make sure I'm not missing anything. So in our home section, you should have an image. All right, I'm going to add this up. It's going to tell, let me just add the starting this thing. So it's just telling Django to look for the image now in assets, image and profile. So let me just go down, add it here. Okay, what I've done is I've added the starting of this folder. So now what I have to do is I have to close it up. So I'm just going to come up here, then copy this to close all the files I'm loading, like to complete the tags. So alright, I think I'm done with that, so I'm going to go ahead and refresh the page. Okay, as you can see, once I refresh the page, Django knows now where to get this image from, where to get all this image and all these static files from. So that's it. We have added our index, our template, or our HTML file. We have added the CSS and all the images in our Django project. So all right, we're going ahead and set up that page and told Django where to find the styling. So what we are going to do now is we are going to make our pages dynamic, that is by adding more views. Remember that if I come here to the admin, all right, I have a home section where I can customize this front page. So that is, I'm having John Doe here, I'm having Halo and ND. So I'm just going to come here now, then I'll create a new home section. So my name is, I'm just going to use John Maron, then I'm going to use hi there. All right, then for the picture, remember that for this picture we need a picture with a transparent background. So to do that, I've left a link in the description that is going to help, like I've left a link in the description to this website which is going to help you to remove the background of your image. So what you want to do is you just drag and drop the image here, then the image is going to get uploaded, and once the upload is done, you'll be able to download it. So I've already added mine to the website and then I have downloaded it, which is this. So I'm just going to drag that and put it on my desktop. As you can see, this picture I uploaded here, then now I downloaded it and it gave me this picture without the background. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add that to my home section. I'm going to go to choose file, go to desktop, and then I'm going to choose that file. Okay, as you can see, I have a home section now. So I've saved that. So as you can see, I've added a home section in my database. And then now if I come here and refresh, nothing happens because I've never told Django how to get that data from the database. So that's where our views comes in action. So what you want to do now is you want to get now the data from a database from here and then send that data to our index.html page. So to do that, I'm going to create the pages here. Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and create a variable that is going to hold all the data from our home model. So the variable is called home, and then what I'm doing is I'm saying from home.objects.latest. It means, remember, in a model, if you go here in our models.py, this is our home section. So we created a variable called updated, which saves the time, or saves the time each time it saves the time a model is being modified or created. So each time I create a model or I modify it, it's going to save that time. And what we want to do is each time we have the latest model, for example, if you have your profile, if you have your name, you have on this website, if you have your picture and the halo, you obviously want to get the latest or the newest data. So what we are doing is we are getting the newest data from our home section using this query. So home.objects latest. So I'm getting the latest object based on this variable called updated. That is, I'm just going to get the time, the name, the greetings, the setting, the picture based on the latest time that was saved in this variable called updated. So home.object.latest. So I've gotten that. So now for me to be able to use that in my template, I have to create a variable that I'm going to send into my template, and that variable is going to be called context. Okay, so what I've done is I've created a variable called context, which is going to hold this variable in our index.html page. So I'm using this context to send this data into our index.html page. So what I've done is this home here is equals to home in our template. So now what I have to do now is I just have to send now a context in the request, and as it means Django is going to return the HTML page plus context, which is having the data called home, or the data from our models called home. So now what we want to do now is we want to connect that from here, like from our HTML page. So now what I'm going to do is I'm still going to use string stack called, like from the Django provides a language called Django templating language, which permits you to get data or use the data you're getting from Python in your HTML page. So to use that, you have to use this. And then now in my context, I had a variable called home. So now home is from this model. Since home is from this model, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use home. Remember, we have a variable called name here. So if I come now to this part and then I use home.name, that's going to get the name of our home section. So if I go now and refresh, remember this is John Marion now. John Doe. If I refresh, it's going to become James Marion. Why? Because I added the variable name called James Marion here, and now it's been outputted here because I've gotten that data from my database using the views. Then now from the views, I've passed it in. So now from the views, I've passed now that data in a context which I've returned in a HTML page. So I've gotten the data from the database. I add it to a context. Then now in that context, now I send now the context in our HTML page, which now I'm able now to use it. So that's basically what I'm going to be doing now for our home section. So I'm just going to copy this. Yeah, this is enough, Lynn. All right, so yeah, I'm just going to do this home dot. I think this was great. Let me just copy that. If you go to your model, you have greetings one. So I'm just going to copy that. Greetings one. Okay. Then here, I'm going to copy greetings two. Copy that. Okay, if I refresh now, I have hi. Oh, all right, that makes sense because I did not change this. Okay, because here I have home.greetings1, my greetings1 is hi and greetings1 is still hi, so I need greetings2. So now I refresh. Why is that? Okay, I refresh now. I have hi there, which is the data I added from my database. The data I added to my database. So there you go. And the last thing I want to add now is in this home section, we have the name, we have the greetings, and then we have the profile, this picture. So I'm going to now add that picture. So yeah, this is the picture. So what I'm going to do now is, okay, I've gone ahead and added the greetings here. So what I'm going to want to do now is to add the picture. So to do that, I'm just going to remove this and then type this in. So from the home, I have a variable called picture, which is this. And then for me to be able to render the picture on the HTML page, I have to pass in the URL. Remember to use all of these to output an image on an HTML page, you need the URL of that image. So I'm going to just use home.picture.url, and then we check now this. All right, as you can see, I have this picture. Maybe I can go ahead and enlarge the picture, but basically that's what we want to do. So we have the data for the home section here that we have fetched now from our database, and then we are outputting it from our templates. So I'm going to go now to the about section. So now we are in the about section. All right, so let me create the views for the about section. So this is basically views for the about section. So in the about section, I'm going to create a variable called about and profiles. In about, I'm going to get the latest about project, the latest about data, and then in profiles, I'm going to get the latest profile data based on about. So this is about.objects.latest. So I'm getting the latest about object based on the variable called latest. Remember, in about we also have a variable called updated, which is we just save the time at which that variable has been, or that model has been modified, and it just get the latest model. So this is what I've done. Then now based on this latest about, I'm just going to get now the profiles, just to be sure that since the about and the profiles are linked. So if I'm getting the latest about here, and then now I pass in, like once I'm getting the profiles, and then I make sure that the profile I'm getting is linked to the about. So now I'm sure that the about and the profiles I'm getting are the latest value. So what I want to do now is I'm just going to go now in my admin interface, then now add an about section. All right, let me just copy from this. So let's just say this is my about section. I'm just going to say use this, add it to my database. Okay, let me use this. All right, it's getting from the hole that I had. Okay, I have that. Then now I'm just going to choose that same image from my desktop. Okay, let's say Facebook, and now just a random link. Let me say GitHub, random link, Twitter, random link. And I'm just going to save that. So I've updated it. So I'm getting the latest about data. Once I get the latest about data, I use now the latest about data to make sure I'm getting the latest profile section. as shown in my views, I get the latest about data, and now I pass in that latest about data to make sure that the profiles I'm getting is linked to the latest about data. So once that is done, now what I want to do is I want to pass this into my context. So I'm having about here. All right, so I've added my about and profiles in my context. That means now the data now is available on my template. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add that here. So yeah, I'm going to add about. Let me just copy this here. Then now this is a title. So yeah, should be about. About, let's check a model. About.heading. About dot. Isn't that? Okay. Then now let me check it if I'm getting it right. Alright, I'm getting it right. So I'll just go ahead and add the rest of it. Yeah, it should be about.career. Yep. This should be about.description. Okay. Then now I'm having an image here. So for this image, let me just copy something here. The same thing here. I'm just going to use that same formatting. So yeah, I'm having the about.picture.url. In about I have bit, okay, in about I have bit profile image.url. So about the profile image.url, and with that we are done with our about section. Let's check that. So I'm going to refresh. Okay, as you can see, this is the data I added from my database. This is the title, the description, and everything from the database as defined here, and it's getting the latest data. So if I go ahead, for example, in my about, if I go ahead and then come here, then I just modify it. So that variable called updated is going to be updated right now. So if I come now here and then I refresh my page, you're going to see that it's going to get now that data, because the views is getting the latest data from the database. And in case when each time you update now your about section, you're just going to get now that latest data. So I'm going to save this and then refresh this back, and as you can see, it's getting the latest data from our database. So now let's go to the skill section. So let me go to the views, and then I'm going to create this skill section. This is a skill section. So in the skills, I'm just going to get all these categories of our skills. So I have a variable called category, and in that variable called category, I'm just going to get all the category object, that is category.objects.all. It means I'm getting all the objects. Oh, what did I do? Okay, I'm just going to copy this. Okay, that's done. I've added the category in my context. So what I'm going to do is, since this category is linked to all, if you come here to category or the skill section, you're going to see that each skill has a category. So I'm going to use this link, this foreign key relationship between the skills and the category to output all the skills in this category. So I'm going to go now to my index.html, then I'll scroll down to the skills section, and here we go. Okay, so I'm just going to delete this. Let's just go and take a look at it. So okay, I'm having development and design. Okay, let me just, I'm going to get rid of design and then get rid of this. Okay, now I have only this. So now I'm going to add all my skills here. So let me go ahead and add it. Okay, let me add that. Here we go. Okay, I think I've added it. This div has been closed here. Oh no. Okay, I think it should be this. It is being closed. So what I'm doing is, remember that a category, a skill has a subtitle and the skill name. So for category in categories, it means I'm looping through the category variable and then I'm using this variable now. So for category in categories, I get now the category.name. Once I've gotten the category.name, now I use the link between the category and the skills. So I get now all the skills from the category. And then now I output now that skill.skillname. So this is what I'm doing. Once I get a category now, I'm linking now, I'm getting now all the skills that are linked to that category, and then now I'm outputting the skill name. So for skills in category, this category that I've gotten, I get all the skills and then I output it here in this span, through this span. Then I close my for and the two for loops. Then if I go ahead and refresh, okay, as you can see, I have only one category in my database, which is mobile development and Java and Kotlin. So let's go ahead and add one more. So I'm just going to add one more. I don't know. Let me just use the meetings. Okay, I've added more data in my skill. So if I refresh that, okay, as you can see, I have more data. If I go to my database, I add more. And there you go. Okay, I've added my skills, and once I refresh, you can see that it's getting the data from the database and displaying it on our HTML page. Then now, the last section is going to be the portfolio section. So now I'm in my portfolio section. In my portfolio section, I have these. Okay, in the portfolio section, I have something, this div. So I have this div now. As you can see, in this div, I have this other div, which is called profile image, which repeats itself, like let's say 1, 2, like repeats itself a lot of time, like 6 times. So what I want to do is I want to change that. I'm just going to use one of it, then I'll use a for loop to display each information. So I'm just going to get rid of these, just to be sure. I think I'm off something. I'm just getting from here. So here. Okay. Now I'm just going to delete this. So now I'm having only this section. So now I'm going to go ahead now and create my views. So if I come now to my views section, okay, let me create my views for, like, let me create the query, the get the data from the database, sorry. So I'm getting the data from the portfolio section. So portfolio.objects.all, I'm saving it in a variable called portfolio. Then what I have to do now is to add that here. Okay, I've added my portfolio in the context. Now, what I want to do is I want to add that to the HTML. Okay, I've added the Django template, like the data from my portfolio here. So what I'm basically doing is for each portfolio, that is, a portfolio consists of an image and a link. So for each portfolio in my portfolio variable, remember that the portfolio variable has several portfolios, that is because I'm getting all the objects, so portfolios.object.all. So for each portfolio in my portfolio, now I get now the portfolio.image.url to display the image, then now I get now the link to the portfolio to display the link on that card. So this is what happens if I refresh this. Okay, I'm having nothing because I have no section for the portfolio in my database. So if I come here, I choose a file for the portfolio section. So let's say if I choose this and I give a name, a link, and I save it, and then I refresh. There you go. I have one portfolio section, which once you click now, it gives you now the view details with that link we added from the database. So as you can see, that's just a dummy link. So let me go ahead and add order for portfolio with a better image. So I'm just going to go here. And just use this. Okay, I've added that. Then now I need a link. And if you come now here, you refresh, you're going to have another image. So let me just clean that up and add beautiful portfolio. All right, as you can see, we've gone ahead and created a portfolio website with Django. Here we have the front end, here we have the admin interface where we can add and update data, and as you can see, the data is being added dynamically. So with that said, you can go ahead now and add your own personalized data and modify this. After that, I'm going to be showing you how to host this website for free in my upcoming videos. With that said, thank you for watching and have a nice day.